son, and in the morning, we will remember them. During the moment of silence, remember those who, as a result of the cruelty of war, are no longer among us, and those who continue to courageously serve in the pursuit of peace and freedom everywhere. Perhaps you know a veteran personally. Grandparent who served in the military or experienced the hardships of the Second World War or the Korean War, or a friend or relative who has served in United Nations peacekeeping or Afghanistan. We are honored to have among us today members of the Appleby community who have valiantly served our country, and the school honor roll reminds us of those from our school community who did not return. There are several courageous individuals of whose courage and sacrifice I'm particularly mindful today. Joe Ryan, a longtime friend of Appleby College, who passed away in 2009, served with my regiment, the Royal Regiment of Canada, during the Second World War. He landed with the Royals in the ill-fated raid on Dieppe in 1942, where our regiment suffered horrendous casualties attacking the sheer cliffs of Puy. He saw his best friend killed, and he himself was wounded. He spent the remainder of the war in a German prisoner of war camp. After the war, and until his death, he worked tirelessly to support the Appleby College Cadet Corps and to educate young people about the war. He took a small group of cadets from this school with him to France and showed them the beaches where he landed, the wall behind which he took cover, the bunkers which he valiantly destroyed, at a place where he was finally captured. Joe carried his experiences with him for the rest of his life. He suffered recurring nightmares in which he relived the terror of landing on the beach and the suffering he endured as a prisoner of war every night since 1945. My friends and comrades, Major Joe Minato and Major Charles Pitkin, both served in Afghanistan in the last decade, and they are now just returning from the United Nations peacekeeping mission in South Sudan. The selfless courage of these men is truly humbling, and I am thankful for their safe return to Canada. I remember also men whom I never met, but with whom I feel a sense of camaraderie. Major Vernon Harcourt DeVos Cole, after whom Cole's house is his name, was a teacher here at Appleby College prior to enlisting in January 1915. The age of 26 years old, and the Canadian Expeditionary Force. He was decorated with the Military Cross, but succumbed to his wounds and did not return from the Great War. Aubrey de Vere Arnold Turquois, who was a prefect at Appleby College, is commemorated in this building, enlisted in the 3rd Battalion Canadian Expeditionary Force. The numbered battalion which represented my current regiment, the Royal Regiment of Canada, in the Great War. Aubrey Turquan, whose high school experience was so similar to mine, and who joined the regiment in which I now serve, was killed in action on the 13th of June, 1916. He is commemorated on the Menin Gate in Belgium because he was never found. He disappeared into the muddy battlefield of the First World War. In comparison to the sacrifices of courageous men such as these, the ceremony of remembrance which we conduct once a year may seem trivial. Indeed, this brief ceremony is the least that we can do to honor those who made the ultimate sacrifice and to show our gratitude for those who returned. There is much more that you can do, and many of you are already doing more than this. Acts of service, especially to the least fortunate and most vulnerable in our society, honor the sacrifices of those who laid down their lives in the cause of liberty. Initiatives in which many of you are involved, including your support for charities such as Dignitas, United Way, and international service projects, are consistent with the ethos of service which motivated Joe Ryan, Mr. Cole, and Aubrey Turquan to volunteer for military service. The duty of a soldier is to protect those who cannot protect themselves. Through service, we honor their sacrifices and help to realize the ideals of peace, freedom and equality, which so many who served and laid down their lives. Canadian soldier and poet John McCrae called upon us to take up our quarrel with the foe, to you from failing hands we throw the torch, to yours to hold it high. If we conceive of the foe as the evil of injustice and oppression, then it falls to us to take up the torch of freedom, justice, and equality. Through service to others, we may do so, and in our daily lives, honor the memory of those who lie in Flanders Field, lest we forget.
Thank you. Aye.